It's like the midway of any fair writ large. It was huge.
They called it the Pike, a stretch of Lindell a mile long and as wide as imagination. There were circus elephants and cliff dwellers. You could visit places like China and Cairo and attend a Bedouin wedding. You could even witness creation and get a taste of the hereafter, washed down with a cold beer enjoyed in the Tyrolean Alps. But when it came time for the final farewell, St. Louis faced a dilemma.
The fair planners had a contractual obligation to demolish the fairgrounds and to return Forest Park to sort of a predetermined landscape. And they were legally obligated to do that. But the problem out on the Pike was that they were all concessionaires, and what they had set up was all theirs. And they couldn't sell it for anything. The costs of demolition were greater than the value of what there was to salvage.
And that's when some started suggesting the Pike be made permanent. But among those who rejected the idea was Washington University. The Pike practically began at its front entrance, so that was the end of the discussion.
In the fairgrounds, you would have looked at stuff and gone, whoa, I didn't know we could do that, or I didn't know that. But the Pike was like just a place to have a good time. Big amusement park.
Of the 60 attractions on the Pike, perhaps the most popular was a horse named Beautiful Jim Key. For 15 cents, you could watch him use blocks to spell his name and even do math. His wonders were later celebrated in a song which included the verse, I can count and I can add. Know my alphabet, and that's not bad. I can even give you change. For a horse, that seems strange.